33:29. Okay, someone can read it loudly. Deuteronomy 33:29.
Happy are you, O Israel.
Who is like you?
People saved by the Lord. The shield of your health. And the sword of your majesty.
That promise verse says, happy are you, O Israel. Or the other way we can say, blessed are you, O Israel. Israel is a blessed people. Amen. Hallelujah. Bible talks that his people are called Israel. After Jesus came to this world and after Jesus died on the cross, we are also becoming his people, and also we are also becoming an Israelite through Jesus Christ. Amen. It's a privilege. Hallelujah. Okay, during the promise message service, I shared about the blessings which belongs to his people, Israel. Okay, three types of blessings God has kept for his children. The one is his increase. The second one is his strength. The third one is his peace. Amen. Three types of blessings belongs to his children. The purpose of God is to increase them. The purpose of God is to give strength to his people. The purpose of God is to give his peace to his people. Amen. Hallelujah. But today, I'm going to talk to you something more about this people of God or the Israel. God's heart is to bless his children. Amen. At the same time, he expects something from his children. Hallelujah. I'm going to talk to you about what he expects from us, why he is expecting these things from us. Amen. Hallelujah. Who are we? We are also called Israel. I want to show you some more verses before we get into the message. I want to show you some more verses. 2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 8. 2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 8.
Now therefore, you say to you, my servant David, thus says the Lord.
The Lord told Nathan to convey some message to David. The Lord said, now therefore, thus shall you say to my servant David.
Thus says the Lord of hosts. I took you from the sheepfold, from following the sheep, to be ruler over my people, over Israel.
To be ruler over my people, over Israel. God called his people as Israel. God called Israel, he said, they are my own people. For his people, God took this one man, David, from the sheepfold, and he brought him as a king to rule over them. Amen. One more verse we can read, 1 Peter chapter 2. Verse 9. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9. Bible calls us as his people.
You are a chosen generation.
A royal priesthood.
A holy nation. His own special people.
Hallelujah. Bible talks about you and me. Here Peter said, you are his own special people. Amen. Hallelujah. In the Old Testament, the name was given to his people is Israel. Amen. New Testament, God said, you are my own special people. That means you are also Israel. Whenever my people comes, you can put the name Israel. Hallelujah. Amen. So remember, we may not born in flesh as a Jewish people or as a Israel, but spiritually, we are also Israel through Jesus Christ. Amen? Okay. Now, I am going to share with you two things about what God expects from Israel. Amen? Psalm 115 verse 9.
O Israel, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their shield.
Amen. O Israel, trust in the Lord. He is their help and their
shield.
There is a message here comes to Israel. What kind of message? Oh Israel, trust in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Many blessings waiting for Israel, but at the same time, God expects something from Israel. Hallelujah. Amen. What is God is expecting from His people? Trust in the Lord. God is expecting His people to put their trust in Him. Hallelujah. Many times it's very difficult to trusting the Lord. Hallelujah. When everything goes well, it's very easy to trusting the Lord. Amen. But something changes, it's very difficult to trusting in the Lord. But this evening, the Lord wants to tell us, hey, you are my Israel, trust in me. Hallelujah. Trust in the Lord. Simple way God wants to say, trust in me. Why the Spirit of the Lord tells here, trust in the Lord? Because He is their help and shield. Because the Lord is your help, because the Lord is your shield, just trust in the Lord. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Many celebrities, many leaders, they put their trust in the protection of the gods. Right? They put the trust, they believe that they will protect them. Yes? Because they know they have all the weapons and everything, right? Yes or no? Many times we are putting our trust upon our 401k, right? We do not know how much it will come or not. But still we are trusting our retirement, right? Yes or no? Easy to trust 401k, but difficult to trust upon the Lord. Amen? Yes or no? Amen? Sometimes we put our trust upon the painkiller, but difficult to put trust upon the Lord. Amen? When the doctor says, if you take this pill, it will help you. Faithfully, we are taking it. Because we trust, if I take this, it will go away, right? Hallelujah. Amen? Many times we are going through the path, it's very difficult to put our trust in the Lord. But here God says, Israel, I am your help. I am your shield. So put your trust in me. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord wants to protect His people. The Lord wants to help His people. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you need His protection? Hallelujah. I need His protection. Hallelujah. He alone can protect me. Amen. Nobody else. When God protects you, nothing can come nearer to you. Amen. Bible says, no evil come nearer to you. Hallelujah. You will not see evil. Amen. These are all the promises of God. I want to show you some more verses. Why God is asking us to put our trust in Him. Psalm 121 verse 4. Psalm 121 verse 4.
Behold, he who keeps Israel.
Behold, he who keeps Israel
shall neither slumber nor sleep.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. 24/7, He is watching over us. Amen. God said, you go and sleep, I will not sleep. I will take care of you. Hallelujah. So put trust in me. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 28, verse 15. Genesis 28, verse 15. How God wants to protect you. How God will be a... Amen. Hallelujah. God gave this promise to Jacob. Behold, I am with you and will keep you wherever you go. Hallelujah. Amen. What a great assurance. God said two promises. I will be with you and I will keep you. Hallelujah. Wherever you go, I will keep you. Amen. Doesn't matter where you are. The protection of God will be upon you. Because He is going to come along with you. That's why God said, put your trust upon me. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that? He is a promise-keeping God. If He say, I will be with you, He will be with you. If He say, I will keep you, He will keep you. Amen. That's why the Lord is asking us to put our trust in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, God will keep you. The Lord will keep you. Amen. Hallelujah. Wherever you go, the Lord will go. Amen. Hallelujah. See, he became like a servant. Hallelujah. If the president goes somewhere, president of this country goes somewhere, always one team of people will go along with him to protect his life. Right? Amen. The Lord wants to become our God, like to protect our life. If you go here, I will go. If you go there, I will go with you. Amen. What a wonderful God we worship. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord said, I want to keep you. Hallelujah. God gave a promise to Jacob, do not worry that you are alone. Amen. That time Jacob did not have a parents with him. Jacob did not have any friends going along with his journey. He was alone. But the Lord said, I will be with you and I will keep you. Amen. Hallelujah. Then God said, I will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have spoken to you. Genesis chapter 31. Genesis chapter 31. 5, 6, 7. How God was very faithful in the life of Jacob. In the life of Israel.
I see your father's countenance that it is not favorable toward me as before, but the God of my father has been with me.
Amen. Hallelujah. Jacob spoke to his wives, Rachel and Leah, about their father, Laban. Right? Laban or Laban? How we need Laban, okay? He said, your father's countenance changed. Your father is not like before. Amen? Not like yesterday. Your father's countenance changed. It's not favorable towards me. But I know one thing, the Lord is with me. Amen? He said like that, right? God of my father has been with me. Hallelujah. Amen? People's face will change, but his face will never change.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Full of glory, full of grace, full of love, full of compassion, full of favor towards to you.
Amen.
That's why the Lord said, put your trust upon me. Amen. Hallelujah. Here, Jacob understood one thing. Things are changing, but he is never changed. Amen. Today, the Lord wants to encourage each and every one of you here. I will never change in my word. I will never change in my love. How many of you believe that? Hallelujah. He's a promise-keeping God. If he says something to you, he is faithful in it. Amen. Hallelujah. We can read the next verse also.
And you know that with all my might I have served your father. Yet your father has deceived me and changed my wages 10 times. But God did not allow him to hurt me.
How many times father-in-law deceived?
Ten times
changed the
wages.
The worldly man also won't do like this. Right? Worldly boss also won't do like this. But the own father-in-law deceived
10 times.
Right? But he realized one thing. But the Lord did not allow him to
hurt
me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Because God promised him, wherever you go, I will go with you. I will keep you. That is the promise of God, which Jacob received from God. Amen. But God allowed certain things in his life. Amen. You can change the wages, but you cannot touch it. You understand? Amen. Some waves can come in our life, but it cannot hurt us. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that? Amen. Everybody has some challenges. But the good news is, it cannot hurt you. Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Someone can. Do you know, all these verses needs to be memorized and by heart, you need to say.
And
yes.
Luke 10:19. Behold, I give you.
Huh.
The last part of it says, nothing shall by any means
hurt you.
Tell your neighbor, nothing will hurt you.
Nothing will hurt you.
Nothing will hurt you. Amen? Hallelujah. Do you believe that?
Amen.
Because God is giving all the authorities in our hands. That's why God says, I am your shield. I am your help. So put your trust upon me. Hallelujah. O Israel, put trust in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Here, certain things God allowed in the life of Israel. Amen. But he did not allow those things to hurt him. Amen. That's why he was serving his father-in-law 20 years. How many years?
20 years.
20 years he was serving because he knew father-in-law is deceiving. But it did not hurt him. Amen. Hallelujah. Many times in our life, the problem is it's hurting us. Right? Hallelujah. Amen. If you are too sensitive, it will hurt you just like that. Immediately it will hurt you. That's a problem. Amen. That's why some people used to say we need to be a thick skin. Right? It should not hurt us. The Lord will allow the things, but the truth is it cannot hurt you.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. That means we need to shake it out like a dust. Hallelujah. You cannot hurt me. I know certain things are happening, but you cannot hurt me because it's a promise of God. He is my shield. He will keep me. Amen. Hallelujah. The things which happened in the life of Jacob did not hurt him. Amen. Today, how is the things happening in our life? Is it hurting you or not hurting you? Amen. Hurting you means we are not accepting the promise of God. We are not believing the truth. Lord, I know it's coming on my way, but it will not hurt me. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. We can read the next verse. Genesis. Genesis chapter 31, verse 7. Same verse. God did not allow him to hurt me. Amen. The devil cannot hurt you. Hallelujah. The Lord will not allow the enemy to hurt you. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 31, verse 12.
And he said, lift your eyes now and see, all the rams which leap on the flocks are streaked, speckled and gray spotted. For I have seen all that Laban is doing to you.
God said to Jacob, I have seen all the things your father-in-law is doing to you. Amen. That means his eyes are always watching over us. Because he promised him, I will keep you. Amen. 24/7. Hallelujah. Nobody can do things like to us. Amen. He is always watching. Whatever is happening, he said, hey, I have seen. Amen. That time, Jacob could not see everything. But the Lord watched everything for his servant, Jacob. Hallelujah. That's why the Lord said, put your trust in me. Amen. How many of you believe that the Lord's eyes are watching over you? Hallelujah. Then why don't we put our trust in the Lord? Amen. Hallelujah. We can read 31:24.
But God had come to Laban the Syrian in a dream by night and said to him, be careful that you speak to Jacob neither good nor bad.
Hallelujah. See how much God concerned about his servant Israel. Amen. His father-in-law planned to go after them and try to capture them, bring them back. But God said, do not speak any good or bad. That means we can say in the other way, be quiet. You are not supposed to talk anything against my son Israel. Hallelujah. See how God took zeal for his servant Israel. Hallelujah. That's why God said, put your trust in me. You can trust me 100%. I am your shield. I am your help. The Lord became a shield for Jacob. Hallelujah. Amen. Because he promised it. Hallelujah. When the father-in-law was changing everything, he was watching over everything. Amen. That's why God said, I have seen everything what Laban is doing to you. Amen. If you read Genesis chapter 31, verse 40, 41, 42.
There I was in the day the drought consumed me, and the frost by night, and my sleep departed from my eyes.
Jacob was talking to his father-in-law about the difficulties he went through because of his father-in-law's house. He said, day and night, my sleep departed from my eyes. I could not sleep. Whether it's a drought or frost, I was taking care of all your sheep. Next verse.
Thus I have been in your house 20 years. I served you 14 years for your two daughters and 6 years for your flock. And you have changed my wages 10 times. Unless the God of my father, the God of Abraham, and the fear of Isaac had been with me, surely now you would have sent me away empty-handed.
Hallelujah. That means Jacob never ran into emptiness. How many times he changed the wages? 10 times. How many years he worked? 20 years. Why he was keep on changing the wages? He does not allow him to be flourished. He doesn't want to give him salary the right way. He deceived him. Hallelujah. But Jacob said, the Lord never allow him to go empty. How many of you believe that you will never go in empty? Hallelujah. There will be a flow in your life continuously. You will see the flourishness of God. Because God of Isaac, God of Abraham is with you. He found it. Jacob found it. The reason I am not going through emptiness because of all these things happened, it's my God. Today the Lord wants to encourage you. You will never go in empty. There will be a feeling of God in your life.
Amen.
Because the Lord is with you. Because He is the one keeping your life. Amen. Hallelujah. God has seen my affliction and the labor of my hands and rebuked you last night. Amen. Hallelujah. What is the meaning of rebuke? Scolding, right?
Threatening.
Like a threatening. If you do something to my son, I'll finish your life. Right? Or be careful. You are playing with my son, Israel. Amen. Jacob did not know all these things. It's all happened the previous night through his dream. God warned him. Jacob found it. The reason God rebuked you, because he is with me.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. See, what extent God went for this one Israel. One man who called us Israel. Amen. Hallelujah. Put yourself in the place of Jacob or place of Israel. The Lord will do the same thing for you also. If someone is giving you, keep on changing the wages, stopping your promotion, one fine day the Lord will rebuke. When the Lord rebukes, no one can stand against it. Amen. That is the last stage. Hallelujah. Sometimes God will allow. Hallelujah. Amen. I was keep on asking the Lord, Lord, you kept him safely and everything. Then why you allowed him to change the wages? Right? The Lord one who kept him safely, he can avoid those things also, right? Amen? Hallelujah. Certain things God will allow in our life to test our heart. Amen? Then only we can lean on Him. If everything goes smooth, whatever you ask, the next day if everything gets, after a while, we will lean on our own understanding. But Bible says, do not lean on your own understanding. Put your trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. But always the Lord will be with you to keep your life safe. Amen. Hallelujah. We can read the verse Genesis chapter 32, verse 6 and 7.
And the messengers,
another time, Jacob went through great fear in his life.
And the
one time his father-in-law came. That time he did not know the father-in-law was coming, but God protected him. But this time he knew who is coming. Because he knew, he had a fear. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Sometimes, you know, it's better we are not knowing some things. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. When we know, then only the great fear will come. Jacob did not know his father-in-law was coming, but God took care of him. But now he knew something is coming. We can read that verse. Mm.
Then the messengers returned to Jacob saying, We came to your brother Esau, and he also is coming to meet you, and 400 men are with him.
This one message is enough to put the fear in our heart, right? Amen. After a long time, after more than 20 years, God asked Jacob to go back to his own place. Because God said, I have seen everything about your father-in-law, what he's doing. Now this is the time you need to go back. God only asked him to go back. So he has to go. Who has to go?
Jacob.
Okay, very good. This side, you are with me? Okay, Jacob has to go, but now he has to go, but somebody is there. His brother, who was planning to kill him. Hallelujah. He took a oath, he took a decision. When I see him, I will finish his life. Now he needs to face him. Hallelujah. No other way. God asked him to go, but now Esau is there. So what he did, he sent some precious gift to his brother. Smart. Amen. Hallelujah. Gift works. Amen. He sent lot of gifts to his brother. Okay. Then the messenger came and told him, okay, your brother also coming with
400 people,
right? They did not tell the 50% of remaining message for why he is coming, right? Whether he accepted the gift or not. Okay. He did not have any idea with what kind of mind setup his brother is coming. He knew only one thing, his brother is coming. He's not coming alone, he's coming with 400 people. Hallelujah. Amen. We can read that verse.
So Jacob was greatly afraid and distressed.
Verse 7. Jacob was greatly afraid
and
distressed, and he divided the people that were with him, and the flocks and herds and camels, into
two companies.
Amen. The first part of that verse says Jacob was greatly afraid and
distressed.
He knew the Lord is with him, because few hours before he spoke to his father-in-law. He said, God of Isaac is with me. Otherwise, you will send me empty-handed. That time he was able to tell him that Lord is with me. The Lord has seen everything, right? Within few hours or within few days, now the great fear and distress came upon his life. Amen. Hallelujah. Many times as a God's children, one day we are encouraging someone. We are telling them, do not fear. Fear not, do not be afraid, everything. But suddenly, the distress and fear can grip our hearts. Jacob went through it. Hallelujah. Amen. See, he was afraid of his own brother. It's another sad thing. He did not fear about some enemies. He did not fear, he afraid about his own
brother.
Hallelujah. It's a very sad thing. Yes or no? Amen. If you have a fear about your boss, it's very difficult to work in that place. You cannot have a peace. You will go through the distress, right? Jacob realized, I know my brother is coming. Hallelujah. Amen. So that fear, distress came upon him. Next verse.
And he said,
maybe we can read verse 10.
If I am not worthy of the least of all the mercies and of all
the truth. And also the verse 7 said, the fear and distress was upon Jacob, but in midst of fear and distress, what he did? He put verse 7, you can read the verse again. 7.
So Jacob was greatly afraid and distressed, and he divided the people that were with him.
We all know the story, right? And throughout the night, what he did? He was
separating
all the herds. He put few things at the front, he put few things at the back, he put all the other wives and children at the front. See, in midst of all the fear and distress, he was very smart. Amen. He was able to function. It's wondering, right? If I go through that path, I cannot do all these things. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
One small distress, right, will paralyze us. We will not do anything. Right? We will try to stop everything. Right? One thing we'll try. Father-in-law is better than
brother-in-law.
At least for father-in-law, the Lord is speaking through the dream. Better we can go back to father-in-law and work 20 more years peacefully. 400 men is coming, right? Amen? Yes or no?
Yes.
But he knew one thing. I know I'm going through distress and fear because my brother is coming. But I know I need to do something now. I will not go back. I will not become paralyzed. I will do something. Hallelujah. Amen. He determined to do something. He determined to give something best to his family. Amen. Because God has given something in his hand to take care of it. He is responsible. Amen. During our time of distress, during our time of fear, during our time of all our problems, God has given something in our hands to take care of it. It's our responsibility. Your fear, your distress, your depression should not make you paralyzed. The will of God is you need to do something on this time, for this time. Amen. How many of you believe that?
Amen.
Amen. With what hope you can do all this thing? The hope of his presence. Hallelujah. I believe that Jacob went through the fear and distress, but in midst of everything, he had a hope. God of Isaac, God of Abraham is with me. Amen. If you read the few more verses, then you know what made him to do all these things. Hallelujah. We can read that verse. Maybe verse 10, 11, 12, brother.
I'm not worthy of the least of all the mercies and of all the truth which you have shown your servant. For I crossed over this Jordan with my staff, and now I have become two companies.
The first thing he did, everything in order, okay, then he realized, this is the time to talk to my God. Amen. Hallelujah. He started to speak to the Lord. I am not at all worthy. And also he recalled everything. What all the things the Lord has done in his life. Amen. Hallelujah. Israel recalled how God was a shield to his life. How God became his help in the past. He said, I am not at all worthy for all these things. I crossed this river with a staff. But now with two
companies.
Hallelujah, amen. During your time of distress, during your time of fear, do not become paralyzed. Whatever you need to do, do. Hallelujah. There are some responsibility in your hand. Do it. Then speak to the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Then recall all the good things God has done in your life. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. he recalled and he said, Lord, I crossed this river with one staff, but you visited me. Amen. You told me that you will increase me like a dust of the earth. We can read that verse continuously.
Deliver me, I pray, from the hand of my brother, from the hand of Esau, for I fear him, lest he come and attack me and the mother with the children.
Amen. Hallelujah. Whatever he went through, he plainly told the Lord, Lord, truly, I am going through fear. I do not know what to do. Hallelujah. He did not ask the Lord, Lord, did you warn him like you warned Laban? See, for Laban, it's a different way. For Esau, it's a different thing. Amen. God will not follow the same pattern all the time. Amen. He is unchanging in his word, unchanging in his promises. But his works are different all the time. Amen. That's why God said, trust in the Lord. Sometimes we will expect the Lord to warn Esau also through the dream. Yes or no? Amen. If God does the same way, everybody can be happy all the time. Amen. The Lord will warn Laban. The Lord will warn Esau. The Lord will warn everyone. The Lord will warn you. But sometimes his ways are different. Amen. He is mighty in works. That is not changeable. But the pattern is changing. So he said, Lord, I am fear about my brother Esau. Amen. We can read that verse.
For you said, I will surely treat you well.
For you said, I will surely treat you
well. Make your descendants as the sand of the sea, which cannot be numbered for multitude.
Amen. He said, Lord, you only told me you will increase my descendants. But now I am having a fear whether the children will survive. My wives will survive through this process. Because Esau is on my way. Hallelujah. Amen. In our life also, many times we are facing Esau. Hallelujah. Maybe it's not a particular person. Maybe something, it's put a fear in our heart. Maybe some interview. Maybe some procedure. Or maybe some process which we are going through. It may put a fear in our heart. It's a Esau in our life. It's a Esau on our way. Amen. But in midst of everything, he is holding on to his promises. Hallelujah. Lord, you only told me my descendant will increase like a dust of the earth. But now the problem is coming towards your promise. Hallelujah. Amen. Bible says, next chapter, Genesis chapter 33 verse 4. He went
but
through
Esau,
the fear.
Esau ran to meet him and embraced him and fell on his neck and kissed him, and they wept.
Amen. Hallelujah. I love this verse very much. What a great relief for Jacob. He thought he will kill him. But instead of killing him, he kissed him. Amen. Who can do all these things? Only God alone can change the hearts of the people. God changed the heart of Esau. He never thought he will receive a kiss. He thought he will kill him. Amen. Hallelujah. God of Israel can change the things in our life. Amen. Maybe you can face some people like Esau in your life. God can change their hearts. Maybe you can face some situations like Esau. God alone can change it. Hallelujah. That's why Bible says your sorrow will turn into
joy.
Amen. The fear of Jacob, the distress of Jacob, the sorrow of Jacob changed in his life because God changed the heart of Esau. Amen. Hallelujah. Today God is going to change Esau's in your life. Maybe you are facing a situation like Esau, but God alone can change it. God will change it. Hallelujah. Amen. Psalm 130 verse 7 and 8. quickly. Psalm 137 and 8.
Mm. O Israel, hope in the Lord, for with the Lord there is mercy, and with him is abundant redemption.
Amen. Hallelujah. God asked Israel to hope in him because there is a mercy, and with him is abundant redemption. Hallelujah. God is asking Israel to put trust in him. Then now God is asking Israel to put their hope in him, because God said he has abundant redemption. Hallelujah. Amen. Job said, my Redeemer lives. He is our Redeemer. He has abundant redemption. Hallelujah. Next verse, we can read the next verse also.
And he shall redeem Israel from all his iniquities.
Amen. God can redeem Israel from all his iniquities. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that he is our Redeemer?
Amen.
He will redeem us from all the iniquities. Hallelujah. Jesus alone can redeem us from all our iniquities. Because of that, he shed his precious blood. Through his blood, we will have a life. Amen. He is able to redeem us from all our iniquities. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why God said, Israel, put your hope in me. I am your Redeemer. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord wants to redeem us from all our problems. Hallelujah. Redeemer means redeeming, or redeeming means he has to give something unredeemed. Amen. Hallelujah. If you put something in pledge, you need to go and pay money and you need to redeem your things. Right? If you put your document in the bank and get the loan, how you can redeem your document? Paying back that money and redeem the documents. Hallelujah. But here the Lord said, Israel, put your hope in me. I am going to redeem. That means I am going to pay your price. Hallelujah. You don't need to pay, but I will pay. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that through his blood we have a victory?
Amen.
Through his blood we will be redeemed.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Through his mighty hand we will be redeemed. Amen. At the right time his mighty hand will come. Hallelujah. One time Peter went through the sinking experience. We all know that, right? The Lord, he said, Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you. The Lord said, come. Peter obeyed to his voice and he came out of the boat. He started to walk on the water. Bible says, suddenly he saw the waves and the wind. He feared and he started to sink. Hallelujah. Amen. But immediately he cried out to the Lord, Lord, save me. Hallelujah. Someone has to redeem him who is sinking in the water now. Hallelujah. Amen. Somebody has to come and help him to come out of this problem. Hallelujah. Nobody's there to come and help him. That's why he knew only he alone can redeem me. The Bible says Jesus stretched his hand and he lifted him up. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Our Redeemer is able to redeem us from every problem. His arms are not shortened. It's stretched forth to redeem us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. How many of you believe that he is your Redeemer?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, he is your Redeemer.
He's your Redeemer.
Amen. He will redeem you.
He will redeem
you. Amen. Isaiah chapter 48 verse 12. Mm. Isaiah 48, maybe Isaiah 48, 17. Mm. Amen. Okay, I am the Lord your God who teaches you to profit, who leads you by the way you should go. Amen. Do you know one thing? When Jesus lifted Peter, what Jesus told him?
Why you doubt that? Why did you doubt that?
Where is your
faith?
Faith. Where is your
faith?
Faith. Amen. Hallelujah. If you read Matthew chapter 14, verse 31, it's very nice to hear that one. Matthew chapter 14, verse 31. Thus says the, and immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you
doubt?"
Amen. Hallelujah. "Oh, you of little faith, why did you
doubt?"
That's why Isaiah 48:17 says, "I am your Redeemer. I will teach you the way you should go." The Redeemer not only redeeming us and also teaching us. Hallelujah. There is a way he expects Israel to go. Amen. God expected Peter to have faith in him. He should not doubt. Hallelujah. He is sinking, but God lifted him up. But God said, why did you doubt? Amen. Oh, you of little faith, why did you
doubt?
Ask your neighbor the same thing.
Oh, you of
ask your neighbor, oh, you of
little faith, why
did you doubt? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. In Tamil, it's very nice. Arpa Viswasiye. Amen. In English, it's very decent. Why? Who you of?
Little faith.
Hallelujah. Amen. Our Redeemer expects us to have faith in time of difficulties. The Redeemer is expecting us not to doubt His power. Redeeming power. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. My Redeemer lives.
Amen.
Raise your hand and says, my Redeemer
lives.
My Redeemer will redeem me. Hallelujah. The last verse, I'm going to finish the second part. Actually, it's the what the Lord expect Israel. Isaiah chapter 44, verse 21. Isaiah chapter 44, verse 21.
Remember these, O Jacob and Israel.
What God is expecting from Israel? To remember. Amen. First we need to put the trust, then we need to put our hope, then we need to remember. Hallelujah. Many times we are forgetting. Hallelujah. We are forgetting which we should not forget. We will remember which we should not remember. Amen. That's a big problem for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Certain things we need to forget, but we are remembering those things again and again and again. Certain things we should not forget, but we are forgetting. But God said, O Israel, remember. Hallelujah. Remember this, O Jacob and Israel.
For you are my servant.
Which we need to remember? We are his
servant.
Servant. Hallelujah. Amen. How many of you believe that?
Amen.
Raise your hand and say, I am his servant. Amen. Lord, I am your servant. Amen. God said, Jacob, Israel, remember this. You are my servant.
I have formed you.
Who has formed us?
Our Lord.
He has formed us. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Everything he has formed us, formed inside of us. Every cell, every nerve he has formed. We can read that verses.
I have formed you, you are my servant. O Israel, you will not be forgotten by me.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
O Israel, you will not be forgotten
by me.
Hallelujah. 44:24.
Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, and he who formed you from the womb, I am the Lord who makes all things, who stretches out the heavens all alone, who spreads abroad the earth by myself.
Amen. See, God is comparing these two things. Creating heavens and creating us. Hallelujah. God said, I stretched out the heavens all alone. The Lord does not need anyone's help. Amen. That's why God said, I have formed you in your mother's womb. Amen. That's why you are my servant. Hallelujah. Every substance is created by God. Hallelujah. We can read the next verse too, brother.
Who frustrates the signs of the babblers?
Isaiah chapter 44. Did you read the verse 2? 1 and 2. Sorry, 1 and 2.
1 and 2.
Isaiah 44:1-2.
Yet hear now,
Amen. Yes. We can read it in English also. Thank you, sister.
Yet here now, O Jacob, my servant.
Yet here now, O Jacob, my servant.
And Israel, whom,
and Israel
I, have chosen.
Whom I have chosen.
Thus says the Lord who made you and formed you from the womb, who will help you? Fear not, O Jacob, my servant, and you, Jeshurun, whom I have chosen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Again, God wants to give you this confirmation. You are created by God. You are formed by God. You are His servant. Amen. Hallelujah. Isaiah 43 verse 1 and 2. Isaiah 43 verse 1. Thank you, sister. Yeah, we can read it in English also.
But now thus says the Lord who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed
See,
you.
See, how many times God is again and again telling Israel, I have formed you, fear not. Then here God said, I have redeemed you. Already I have redeemed you. Amen?
Amen.
God has redeemed us already. That's why God said, O Israel, put trust in the Lord. O Israel, trust in the Lord. Amen?
Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine.
You are mine. Next verse.
When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Whenever God says, you are my servant, that means He is responsible for us. Because He is our master. Hallelujah. Master is always greater than the servant. He knows how to take care of His servant. Amen. Hallelujah. One time Moses had a challenge in his life. But God immediately appeared to Aaron and Miriam. God told them, He is not like something you are thinking. If I want to talk to some prophet, I will talk to them through dream or vision. But Moses is not like that. I am talking as a friend talking to his friend. He is seeing my face. Amen. Hallelujah. The only reason God took zeal for Moses, Moses was the servant of God. That's why God said here, Israel, Israel, you are my servant. Hallelujah. That means He will take a zeal for wherever He has to speak, He will speak. Wherever, whenever the enemy comes like a flood, He will raise a banner. Amen. Moses did not pray, but he appeared himself. Hallelujah. That's why I am not praying, Pastor. It won't work always like that. Amen. Because the reason Moses did not pray, they were his own brother and sister. I will not pray against my brother and sister. Of course, later on, he prayed in a different way. When the Lord gave them a punishment, Moses said, Lord, have mercy upon them. That is the heart of Moses. Amen. But the Lord said, He is my servant. How can you talk against Him like this? Why you did not have a fear to talk against Him? Amen. Hallelujah. Only reason, Moses was the servant of God. Amen. Today God is seeing you as a servant. Amen. He will take the same zeal for you and me also. That's why God said, Israel, remember this. You are my servant. Hallelujah. Amen. What a great privilege. What a great blessing to be a servant of God. Amen. Hallelujah. You are formed by His own hands. He has called you by your own name. Isaiah 43:1, He said, you are mine. Hallelujah. Amen. There is a seal upon us, belongs to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. Whenever the enemy see, the enemy